Today we gonna do some navy beans, white beans, with rice. And I got some tasso to go in the beans. So we gonna get started with these. I gotta wrench them and sort them in a colander. A colander. Colander, calendar, who cares? Now y'all missed this. I opened this bag. I didn't need no knife. And this is a bag of beans made by Camellia. Let's see. From New Orleans, Louisiana. See, we got union bags down here. No cussing involved. Imagine that. So we're going to wrench these in the zinc. And look for rocks. I don't see none. I hope they ain't white rocks like all these little beans is. But we're going to try to chew on them. Dennis will like us then, huh? Now for those of y'all who ain't from Louisiana and don't know what tasso is, it's basically extra smoked ham. They make this special. It's a ham, or it's made with pork. They make it with turkey too, but I'll never buy that. And we use it for seasoning, and it's real good. You can see all the extra seasoning on the outside, and it's smoked longer. It's got a real good flavor for beans. If you can't find tasso, use ham. Alright. I got my tasso all cubed up. I got some pick sweet seasoned blend, Trinity in a bag. Let's see where this is made. This is made in Tennessee. How come y'all can't find that up north? That's kind of halfway up and down the states. Damn. Alright, so I got some extra light olive oil. I don't want regular olive oil in this, but I don't want that flavor. You can use any kind of oil you want. Just don't use motor oil or transmission oil. I'm going to put some of this seasoning blend in here. Because this is made in Tennessee, yeah, I figured that. It's non-union. I got some fans up there, too. That's good. Look over here. We're going to put about that much. About half the bag. And this is a 1 pound bag. So that's probably about 2 cups. With the tasso. And then we're going to put them beans in there with the water. And get this to cooking. And the vegetables have been sweating down for about 10 minutes. I've been stirring them. Put that tasso in there. I'll go ahead and pour us about 10 cups of hot water in there. Along with the beans, they've been thoroughly rinsed in the zinc, in the colander. We're going to stir this and return it to the boil. I got to put a little bit more water in here. These beans are going to swell up and cook down, and then we're going to adjust them for seasoning after a good hour. Oh! I almost forgot. Garlic got to go in there. Stand by, boy. Garlic. Yeah, country.
I'm sorry.
All right. So I got 2 old hamburger buns in there. And I'm going to dump some pet milk on them, or evaporated milk, whatever you want to call it. And I got some onions. I decided rather than using that sausage, I'm going to make some hamburgers. Not hamburgers, boy. Meatballs. It's garlic powder. It's Italian seasoning. Come on out of there. And we got some black pepper. And we got some kosher salt. About a teaspoon of each of those dry ingredients. All right, now these meatballs are missing a few key ingredients to make them real Italian meatballs, but we're not really making Italian meatballs, we're making Cajun meatballs, boy. The ingredients would be Parmesan cheese and flat leaf Italian parsley. And I decided I'm gonna go ahead and bake them off in the oven first, and then I'm gonna fry them to get a little crispier crust on them, all right? So when you're forming your meatballs, keep your hands wet. I'm gonna go get my hands wet in the zinc and then roll them out and put them on here and bake them, all right? All right, so I done baked them meatballs off in the oven. Now we're kind of frying them off, give them a little crispier crust. And we're gonna have them with some brown gravy on them white the beans, which are coming along really nice. Over there, boy. White beans with tasso, yum. And all Cajuns gonna eat this over rice. So what I'm gonna do is make some Cajun brown gravy. It's made by Louisiana Fish Fry Products. See, it opens Union style. No, it don't. I didn't tear where it said tear here. That's all right. So I got some cold water in the pot. I'm gonna put the gravy mix in there and give it a shake about. If all you can get is McCormick, use McCormick. Who cares? This got a better flavor though, boy. And I'm gonna put them meatballs that I done fried off in there. And this gravy gonna get thick. All right, boy, so I got 4 cups of water in that pot, and I'm gonna put in 2 cups of rice. It's not rocket science. We're not trying to build nuclear battleships, submarines. We're gonna put some salt in here. There, kosher salt. And we're gonna go get this to boiling. We're gonna put the rice in there after it comes to the boil. Then we're gonna bring it to a second boil after I pour the rice in. And turn it down to simmer. Cover it for 20 minutes. Are you paying attention, boy? Alright, so I done greased up a thing here with lard or shortening or whatever. And I got some cornbread mix right here. And we're going to dump an egg in there. We're going to dump another egg in there. And I got to measure out some milk. And it's going in there too. Alright. So here's that cornbread mix. Now, you know, you can put jalapenos in here, real corn. You can do anything you want with this. You know, we're just going to dump this in there and go bake it off. So stand by while I get the rest of this batter out of here. Because I can see this bowl being about non-union. Come on out of there. Alright, boy, so I got 1 cup of water, 2 cups of water, and I'm going to put in, no. Alright, boy, so I got 4 cups of water in that pot. We're making some hamburgers. So I got some hamburger meat I'm going to put up in there, and we're going to make up some quick hamburgers and go fry them.